Hi, I'm Senator Cory Gardner, and welcome to a conversation about the Great American Outdoors Act. I'm joined in this conversation today with Jeff Crane, the president of the Congressional Sportsmen's Foundation, who's got a lot of experience around the world, quite frankly, in conservation, in hunting, and wildlife, and wildlife management. So, Jeff, why don't you introduce yourself, talk a little bit about your background.
Well, first, thank you very much. Again, I want to thank you, Senator, for your leadership on this bill. We would not be here today without your leadership in the Senate and working with the administration. So let me go on record of saying thank you. What a historic day. I was proud to be there.
The Congressional Sportsmen's Foundation is one of the most effective and powerful organizations and well-respected organizations that has a voice in so much of what we do related to our outdoors. And you made the bill better, and I can't thank you enough for that.
Thank you for allowing us to come in and talk to you and for agreeing to and to add those components to it. It was a fantastic day. So, and I'm glad to be here. I was very fortunate as a young man to have a dad that hunted and fished. And even though I grew up right around Washington, D.C., I got started in the outdoors at a very young age, and he started me, and then I got involved in Boy Scouts and was with a real active Boy Scout troop. And so I've been a lover of the outdoors since I was a little kid.
So your experience with both the Department of Interior, obviously our national parks, our wildlife refuges, BLM grounds, and beyond, and the work of the Forest Service at the Department of Agriculture. Tell me a little bit about how, both from the hunting and shooting perspective and the work with those two agencies, but also the Congressional Sportsmen's Foundation, what the Great American Outdoors Act means to the people that you work with, the land that we all work together to serve.
This was our top legislative priority, by including the other federal public lands, mainly the refuge system, BLM, Forest Service lands, those are where our constituency of fellow hunters and anglers recreate. There's in the neighborhood, and I want to get the numbers right, 25 million hunting days and 45 million fishing days on these public lands. And so by improving them with what you did with your bill, that's just going to make the experience that much better, and hopefully we'll get more people involved and people get to see the great traditions of hunting and our federal public lands are a treasure that this country has, and we as taxpayers all own it. And so by your bill, we're going to improve the access, we're going to improve the facilities there. It just puts a big smile on my face, and thank you, Senator.
Well, thank you. And when it comes to the outdoors, I mean, it's because you've got obviously people who are going out hunting, fishing, enjoying the outdoors, but it also means an economic impact in businesses across the country, people going in and buying supplies, equipment, gear, somebody stopping at a restaurant, going to a hotel. Talk a little bit maybe about the economic impact that our sportsmen have and how this will help benefit economically around the country.
It's kind of ironic because hunting and fishing is something we do sort of in small groups with family and friends, and you don't think of us collectively, but it's over $100 billion economic generator to the economy here. And in rural areas, a lot of times those hunting and fishing seasons, the small motels and the gas stations and the convenience stores, and of course the guides and outfitters and whatnot, they all rely on that. So it's a force multiplier in terms of the economic side. And again, your legislation is just going to improve those opportunities and the facilities and the ability to go enjoy that experience. And so hopefully it'll get more participants, generate more money. And so it'll be an economic driver as well as good for conservation.
Now, do you have a favorite place? Is there a favorite place? If you had the opportunity to go out today somewhere, where would you go? Where would it be? What would you be doing?
So I'm going to get in a lot of trouble if you ask me for my favorite park, because it's not in
Tell us exactly where it is and what we need to bring with us.
It's probably, I love Yellowstone in the lower 48s, you know, and it's just such an iconic park. And I think of President Theodore Roosevelt and, you know, establishing that and just the diversity. But I mean, the park system is so, so vast. Probably I use the refuge systems around the country more because they're more friendly and open towards hunting and fishing just by the way they're designed. And Blackwater Refuge is right over on Maryland's Eastern Shore, is right next to where I hunt and fish a lot. So, but I enjoy getting out on the federal public lands. And again, it's just a, it's a vast treasure of the United States. So it's nice to be an American and have them.
Yeah, it certainly is. And when you look around the world with your experience outside of the United States, you know, who could we learn from in terms of managing our public lands, or is the United States leading the field when it comes to our efforts to protect our public lands?
I'm going to unabashedly say we are leading the way. And with your legislation, we're going to have the dollars to improve that experience, to improve our conservation. And so kudos again for your leadership. But our network of federal public lands and the management of them here in the United States is the world leader, in my opinion.
All right. So now I've got a couple lightning round questions for you, Jeff.
All right. If you're ready. Let's go.
And, you know, none of the above, however you want to answer. All right. If you're given the choice, ski or snowboard?
Ski. I'm way too old for a snowboard.
I hear you now. All right. Here's a tough one. Hunting or fishing?
I got to think about this one. I fish in the summertime and hunt the rest of the year. So you're not going to trap me into the either or.
You're not going to take that one word answer, yes or no. It's a yes or no question. Hunt or fish, both.
You're making me do that. I'm pleading the fifth.
That's right. All right. You know, you got a canoe or kayak or paddleboard. I'll throw in a new one.
I'm old school. I'm a canoe guy.
Yeah.
So. Yeah. I've kayaked, but I feel steadier in a canoe, and I love a canoe. So.
Yeah, and all right, last question. This is a tough one. Hike or bike? Which one?
There's no question for me. I'm too clumsy to be on a mountain bike. I'll hurt myself. So it's definitely I'm safer on my own 2 feet. So.
Well, Jeff,
it's just great what you've done for us. Thank you so much. Can't wait to see it hit the ground and feel the impact and. I'm ready to go out and see it again, but really ready to see it after we put some of this influx of dollars into the management and maintenance. So thank you again, Senator. Really appreciate your leadership.
Well, Jeff, thank you for that. Thanks for the work that you continue to do and the partnership we have with our country's public lands and conservation efforts and access to hunting and fishing and how we can improve on that going forward.